Hey everyone, it's Jen. Thank you so much for joining me today. Today I have some project shares for KS Craft. I am guest designing for Hannah for this month. I'm very excited about. There are so many cute dyes this release. Lots of fruit and ice cream and summery kind of dyes. So I love summer crafting. It's not my favorite season weather-wise, but I love summer crafting. So I was very anxious to get started or do some more projects. I already have one video up that will be on my channel if you haven't seen it yet. But anyway, I have some more die sets to share with you today and some projects. So I will link all these down below in the description box. They will be on the AliExpress site. They could be on the Amazon storefront too. I'm not sure, but I always link to the Ali site. And I will show you the projects, take some measurements. Of course, if you have any questions, please let me know in a comment and I'll get back to you. All right, so the first die set we have is this one. It's called the Watermelon Shaker. So it's really cute. It comes with a backing piece right here. And then this is the frame if you're gonna make it into a shaker, and it has some nice stitching detail on it. And then it comes with a crust or rind layering piece. And I said crust because you could make this into a pizza slice too, because it does come with these like kind of weird circle looking dies, and those look like pepperoni when you cut them out. I did make a pizza one, I'll show you. And then it also comes with watermelon seeds, which I forgot to put in my watermelon project, but they are there if you want. So really cute, simple die set that you can make some really pretty projects with. I also used for this one a word from Fruit Shadow Words, and this comes with strawberry, fruity, sweet, lemon, cherry, and fresh. And I use sweet in this project. So here's the watermelon one that I made. Isn't that cute? I love that word sweet. It's like very narrow, so if you put it on top of an embellishment, you could still see a lot of the embellishment behind it, so that's why I liked it. So I used the Sunshine on My Mind paper pad from Graphic 45 for this project. It's just perfect. The background paper that I used is like the watermelon, the red part with the seeds in it. So I guess I didn't really need to use the seed dye, but it would have been nice to put in there as well. And I used some watermelon clay bits and a bunch of diamond dots and some clear sequins as well. And I used all the different layering pieces. I used Walmart foam board to make it into a shaker, and I used acetate, of course, to hold all of the shaker bits in. Let me measure this for you in case you are wondering how big it is. It's about 2 7/8 top to bottom. And then side to side, it's about 2.5 inches. So super, super cute. And let me show you the pizza one that I made too, which I think is also fun. This one I used another word. This one is from the ice cream words. Where's that set? Oh, here it is. The ice cream shadow words. And I used the word yum, and it has an exclamation point on it. It also comes with the words ice cream, sweet, treat, creamery, yum, and frozen. So here's the pizza one. Isn't that adorable? I just used some tan paper for the crust part, yellow paper for the background, and then those are the little pepperoni pieces I cut out of some dark red paper, and then just used some coordinating sequins and diamond dots for the inside. There's the word yum from that ice cream shadow word set, which I double cut and just, staggered them a little bit to give it a little more shadow there. And then I used a red and white gingham for the back because I thought that looked kind of like, like a pizza restaurant sometimes has those kind of tablecloths. So yeah, super cute, right? This would be really fun on a card, maybe even like a boy's card, So yeah, those are the two different ways you can make it. I'm sure there are other variations, maybe make it into a pie slice too. That would be super cute. So yeah, those are my two projects for that. Hope you like it. Let's move on to the next one. Okay, this one's so cute. It's the 3D beach bag, and I couldn't wait to put this together. So like I said in the video where I introduced the dies, it comes with this piece here that has a really nice handle, but then it has layering pieces for the handle too. It has this one and then a third one too. So it makes a really nice substantial handle. It's not a third layering piece, but a third handle piece. And then it comes with this part. This is a frame that you can make it into a shaker if you want to, which I did for the front of my bag. This is the bottom and sides of the bag. You just kind of curve it under the bag. So you cut that out twice. That has a layering piece too, which I did not use, I don't think. And then it comes with words too. It comes with beach, sunny, vibes, and days, which are really pretty. So let me show you the bag that I made. I think it came out so, so cute. Okay, this is it. And let me just adjust all the little doodads I have on it. So yeah, isn't that adorable? I used some beachy paper that I had that I thought, you know, would just be perfect with the beach bag. You don't have to make it into a beach bag. You could just make it into a little tote bag, you know, but why not since it's summer and it does come with the nice words. So I used beach vibes. Again, I double cut the words and staggered them a little bit. And then I cut out the shadow as well. I did make the front into a shaker. The back is just plain, so that's how it looks without the shaker, which is just super cute as it is. You don't need to make it into a shaker, but of course a shaker is always fun to add. That's the sides. I was going to add layering pieces to the sides. I even cut them out of the same paper from the front, but I just like how it looks plain like that. And if you turn it over, you could see where you join the two side pieces. And you just bend the glue tabs and glue them into place. You know, just hold it as you go along. I did use wet glue to glue mine together. And then I also used some charms in my stash, some summery charms. This one is like a ship's wheel that I got on Etsy. And I got this trim recently from Hobby Lobby. I just love it. And then I added some of these charms too, a little sandcastle and a little sun that I actually made these two into charms by using clear bales. I just glued them on, so you could do that with your cabochons. And then I added a duck too, which was already a charm. And for the shaker part, I added just, you know, lots of colorful kind of sequins just to, you know, go with the colorful vibe of the paper. And I just think it's so, so pretty, right? What a good way to present some gifts. So let's measure this. This is a nice size. It's about 5.5 inches from side to side. Top to bottom, including the handle, is about 4.75, about. Not including the handle, it is about 3.5. And then it's nice and deep. I won't count the shaker in that depth, but otherwise it's about 2 inches. So, you know, you can fit a lot of things in here. And if you use double-sided paper, it just looks so cute. So you can see those glue tabs there where I glued it. And it does even have like reinforced tabs on the side, so it makes it nice and strong. So this is a nice, sturdy bag. You can fit a lot of things in here. I have, you know, I would love to give this to a crafty friend, and I'd be proud to give it to them because I just think it's adorable. So hope you like that too. I only made one of those so far, but yeah, it's a very fun project. Now mine's a little top heavy because of all my charms here, so I've just been, I used these sequins in it. These are from Michaels from, I thought they were Creatology. They might be, but anyway, I use those and I'm just kind of holding them in there to make sure it doesn't fall over. All right, so let's move on to the last project. And this one I use the fruit straw toppers. So this one comes with all of these different fruits. And if you have the straw topper set from last September, that's what this is here, the straw topper maker. These fruit are designed to fit perfectly on the straw toppers. If you go to the product page on Ally, this is listed as an option if you want to pick this up along with the fruit set. But again, you don't have to use it as straw toppers. You could just use them as fruits for your projects. It comes with the star fruit with two pieces, a background piece and a layering piece. Comes with a pear, an apple, a lemon, a pineapple slice, and then like a half a pineapple slice. Comes with the strawberry set, the, you know, the front with the seeds cut out, the base, and then the greenery, and then these pieces for the watermelon too. So I did make mine into straw toppers just because I thought that would be fun, and you know, why not make it the way it was intended. So these are all the straw toppers that I made. I just put them in this little cup that I got from Ally, and I'll show them to you individually. Here's the lemon. How cute is that, right? I double cut this one just to, you know, add a little depth to it. And then I added some yellow Nouveau drops to it as well. This lemon cuts out little like embossed circles. So I just put dots where all the circles were. And yeah, super cute, right? And I used the smallest one of the straw topper makers and just glued that onto the back of the lemon and put the straw through it. So I have some straws in red and some with the strawberry. So there's the lemon. Here's the pear. I cut it out twice. out of the gingham paper and the one with the hearts and just kind of fussy cut the leaf off. And then I colored in the stem with a gold paint pen. So really cute, right? And then this one is a strawberry. I made two strawberries. Here's one with the gingham paper and a white background. And then here's the watermelon, which I used some green glitter paper for the rind. I thought that was super cute. And I did use black glossy paper for the background piece so it would show, so the seeds would show through, because that top piece cuts out the spots for the seeds. Here's the other strawberry I made. I put a little foam square behind it because for some reason this one wasn't staying up on the straw. So anyway, that's the other strawberry I made with white paper that has red polka dots on it, and I used pink for the background of that. Let me turn that one around. Yeah, I don't know why that one, I think I used all the same straw maker pieces, but maybe I used a bigger one for that one. So let's just move those over and I'll show you the other ones. Here is the star fruit, which I just used some green ink to just blend on the tips of that, because I know star fruit were yellow, but I knew that there's a little bit more to them. So they do have a little bit of like green tint to the tips of the fruit. So I just added a little bit of green ink to that. Nothing crazy, just a little. Here's the half a pineapple slice, and I double cut that one as well with yellow gingham and yellow paper in the background. And then here's a whole pineapple slice and double cut that one as well. It just makes it a little bit more sturdy, and I think it makes it a little bit more interesting to look at if there are two papers. And the last one is the apple with some gingham paper. And again, I fussy cut the leaf and use some gold pen for the stem. So let me measure a couple of these fruits for you, just so you get an idea of how big they are. Like this pineapple slice is about 1 3/4 inches. Let's see what else. The watermelon slice is 1.5 inches, about. The strawberry is about, well, counting the stem, it's about 1 5/8 or so. Yeah, something like that. So just to give you an idea of the different sizes, and like I said, you know, you can use these fruits on anything. It doesn't have to be straw toppers, but how cute will these look like on your summer, buffets or something like that? I have which I've shown several times, or I've told about. I have a hutch in my kitchen that has all my seasonal display on. So I'm going to leave them in this little cup. I might put some floral foam on the bottom just so that they stand up the way I want them to, but I think this will be a nice addition to my summery displays. So those are all my projects. These die sets will be linked down below. If you have any questions, please let me know. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon with more crafty videos. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.